Agreed. Okay, students, let's start. Okay. Okay. Did you revise? Revise. In general, where are the shops? You know any idea about that? Lower mass action. Lower mass action. Okay. So you know that K is the equilibrium constant. We can revise. Last day, we go through initially what do you mean by reaction, different type of reaction, homogeneous, heterogeneous reaction, reversible, irreversible process, conditions. After that, we go through equations in that law of mass action. For example, forward reaction, there is a ratio, you know, KC. This is called what, equilibrium constant KC, not K. K even KC, no problem. Okay. So, it is a ratio of KF divided by KB. What is this? This is forward reaction, this is backward reaction. This much only we discussed, right? Okay. Also, we discussed too how we can represent, right? So today we can go through. One more thing, students. This is one of the important things. KC can represented by KC is there depending upon the concentration. Or in the presence of pressure also we can represent the concentration. Partial pressure form. KP. KC. Pressure related. This is concentrated. Liquid one. This is related to gas. Of course gas. This is related to gas. This is related to liquid. Anybody we can expect that lady, that girl. Can we expect in offline mode? You are Sages. Next week onwards. It's not here. Apurva, Venita, and Sanjay. Three. Okay. So this is the condition KPKS is there. Okay. One more thing, students. Representation of KP for liquid one. Liquid one. KP for gaseous one. Now here. Can we start with some questions? We can practice. Write down the question. Question. Write first question. Okay. Write expression. Write expression. And unit, okay, expression and unit for KP and KP for the reaction they are given to you. Write expression and unit, both expression as well as unit for KP and KC for the reaction. Reaction is given calcium carbonate, okay. Calcium carbonate, how they dissociate, in any idea? Calcium carbonate will dissociate. Calcium monoxide plus carbon dioxide. Okay, you want to by heart this one. So most frequently asking without equation, they will tell like this, what about the dissociation of calcium carbonate? They will never give you what about the product, but you want to think. Then dissociation is formed calcium monoxide, then after the removal of carbon dioxide is gas. Clear? This equation is given to you. Okay? This equation is given to you and then asking what about the KPKC representation. Okay. Here students, you know that calcium carbonate is a solid. Calcium oxide is also a solid. But here carbon dioxide is a gas. With the help of this much information, can you represent KPKC? KP. How will you represent KP and how will you represent the K? Try first. You know KP, equilibrium constant, product upon reactant. Here KP little bit different. You want to think on it? Yeah, we can neglect the solid. Only consider water. Yeah. So what about the representation? Tell me. Students, one more thing, unit. Suppose, one more thing, concentration, representation in unit wise. Here you can see KC form. How will you represent concentration unit? Mole? Mole only. Concentration. What do you mean by definition for concentration? How many number of moles dissolve in a particular solution? So what about the unit? Mole per liter. This is the equation. Mole. Okay, so concentration represents a mole upon liter. Mole, how many moles dissolve in how many quantities? This is the unit for C. KC term unit is moles per liter form. But KP term, we can use another pressure unit. Which one? ATM. ATM na? ATM is a very important unit for representing pressure related term. Okay. These are the unit wise representation for you. Then first you want to find out KP, then KC. After that you can give that unit also. Try this one and then show me how your approach on it. Tell me. KP. Can you tell them? KP. KP, yeah. KP you want to represent, we can't represent in a square bracket. Instead of that, you can represent in a partial pressure form, P. So, gas will represent always in the P form. Okay, partial pressure of CO2 only. This much only, no? CO2 only. Okay, then in unit, only one. One only, no? Or unit wise equal to unit wise ATM. Sorry, ATM. Then here, AC. How will you represent? Product upon reaction. How? Tell me. CaO. Then CO2 upon Ca CO3 in square bracket. This much clear? Okay. So here one more thing. Here in a sample, here is the gas sample. Okay, here the solid sample is present in it, suppose. So if we counting the number of solid molecule, solid or gas, which one is higher? Solid, of course. So what we want to do, this is a rule. While we are representing calcium oxide CO2, this much correct, but here you can see CaCO3, this is a solid one, pure solid. That concentration is considered as a unity. One. What about the remaining? Then calcium oxide concentration and then carbon dioxide concentration. This much only. Why? Because this is one. Concentration is termed as one. Because if we comparing the molecular form, the solid is very high. So it is termed, it turns into a one form, unity form. If you compare the particle, CaO is there, but in the denominator, mainly numerator, not like that, but denominator one, na, we can neglect. Okay. Not this one, it's not possible. Also, only one reactant is also with us. Okay. That reactant is converted into product. So here we not possible, but this is the rule. Okay, ratio wise. What is the reason? Look na, here, look here. What is the reason? Here only one solid only. There is nothing is mixed in it. It's a pure one. But after the formation, look, carbon dioxide is there, CO is a mixture type. So we couldn't separate calcium oxide directly from this. But here this is only one only. So pure one. We are assuming it's a pure one. Okay, so pure solid means? Okay. Clear? Another example. Another equation, you want to do it yourself. N2O4 is in gas form. N2O4 in gas form. In equilibrium with 2NO2. It is a gaseous form. Find out the Kc. Kc. Apurva, you want to repeat again? Which one want to? I want to repeat. No. Kc means it is a product by reaction only. But what we are telling Kp only related to gas. That's only. Last one, Kc. Okay, in the last question, Kc means product upon reaction, na student. So here product it was carbon dioxide, then calcium oxide divided by CaCO3. So concentration of CO3 become what? According to there is a rule in it, related to rule. Okay, solid is a constant taken as a unity. So it is neglected, then remaining one is considered as the Kc. Okay, Apurva. Clear? Finish? KP, you want to tell? Can you? N2O4. Okay. A unit wise, how we can represent? ATM. How want to represent ATM unit form? Listen me. What happens? Unit wise, how want to represent? Here the power is 2. Product side power 2. So 2 minus reactant 1. So minus 1. So ATM. Kc is like a Kc. Actually, Kc is related to pressure. It will only consider the concentration of gaseous constituent. It will neglect the condition of solid and liquid. This is the main difference. Okay. Okay, then tell me what you mean by what about Kc? What about Kc? Dhruv. Of unit mol per liter representation how same square minus 1 so mol we are checking different condition okay next one let's see the different okay
Ma'am, please.
Ah, Vinish. What happened? What would be your question? Type. Text me. is better, otherwise. Can I move to next question? Third one. Do it. Okay.
Ma'am, please send the previous answer question. Question of previous question.
Sorry? Can you, Lakshmi?
Answer of previous question.
Answer of previous question. Okay, okay. Previous question answer. Kc equal to NO2 square bracket upon square, NO2 square upon N2O4. Okay. It's unit wise representation, moles per liter. Moles per liter. Okay. Very simple only. Okay, do it this one. Third one. Write an expression and unit for Kp-Kc for the reaction. H2O, water, in equilibrium with the H2O gas. This is liquid. Another one is gas. Do it. Tell me the Kc answer. Tell me. Concentration of H2O upon H2O. Okay, this is your answer. Do it. Wait a second. Kc. Pressure of H2O. This much only. So this is right. But here, you want to consider another condition. In this case, this is a pure liquid, na? Nothing becomes mixed in it. That's why the concentration of pure liquid becomes going to unity. So, okay. So what happened? If this concentration is going to 1, so their answer becomes concentration of H2O only. Okay, this is for yes. This is for Kc and Kp also partial pressure of H2O only. This is for yeah. Okay, one more thing. What type of reaction is this, student? It's a phase equilibrium. It is a phase equilibrium. What is it? It is a phase equilibrium. You know, liquid to gas evaporation is there. It is a chemical or physical change? Physical. I already mentioned, change of state is a, it is a physical equilibrium, not a chemical equilibrium. Physical equilibrium. Why? Because phase change is a, and one of the examples for phase equilibrium, example for physical equilibrium. Correct. Physical. This is clear? Okay, Vinny, you are typing H2O bar H2O. So, what happened here, Vinny? H2O is going to unity. So, we can neglect the term and the remaining only concentration of H2O. Got it? Because that is a pure liquid. Similar to previous question. Next condition, do it. Copper plus 2Ag plus in equilibrium with the copper plus 2 plus 2Ag. Okay, here solid. Here aqueous. Here also aqueous. Here solid. Thank you. Kc first. Okay.
Oh.
Here aqueous. The liquid. Here aqueous. This one, you know, everything. This aqueous. Okay, Kc. Concentration of CH3CO minus plus concentration of H3O plus plus 4 divided by. Tell me. This much only? Now understood. So liquid we can neglect it. Because there is pure one, nothing is mixed in it. That's we can. What is the Kc? Hello, Vinny, what is the Kc?
Zero, ma'am.
Kc. Kc equal to? Tell me.
Zero. Zero.
Very good. Kc equal to zero because there is no more H. So now this section is over. So keep in mind what are the conditions, you know? Like water, solid form, elemental form, where concentration becomes unity. These are the conclusions. Next section. Kc. Who says Kc will not zero, but Kc equal to zero? Apurva. Kc equal to zero, okay, not Kc. Kc you can easily find out from the concentration of remaining reactant and product ratio. Okay, Apurva. Yeah, right. Kc equal to zero. Next section, students. Okay. Now we want to go through relationship between Kc, Kc, you know how to represent. But with the help of the numericals come from this area. How? Because suppose they will, Kc they will give to you. You want to find out Kc. So there is a relation in it. You want to study the relationship equation wise, then we can solve lot of numericals. Okay. So relation between Kc and Kc. This is our next task. Okay. Okay, we can represent a simple equation like this. 2a plus 3b suppose 2c. B plus E in suppose. Simple. Okay. Suppose these are the nature. Gas, liquid, solid. Then after that, the product will become gas, gas. In nature. Okay. Tell Kc. Tell. Kc equal to concentration. Right. Concentration of B. Concentration of E. E divided by concentration of A square, concentration of B. Okay. It is not a pure form. It is not like that. Do you know this is the liquid solid means water. Water we will consider, the concentration of water will consider as a one of the unity because pure water. Okay, not only water. Solid means, suppose calcium carbonate like reaction side only one solid is there, we can neglect that one. Not like that. Okay, so this really you don't know which is water or maybe the possibility. So we want to consider here. Okay. Kp, Kp? Right. Sorry. What I told you, solid liquid is neglected, na? Correct. So, S square only. next one, sorry, sorry, my mistake. Next one, Kp equal to D, E, next, yes, okay, my mistake. So this is the thing, you know, what about here, hello, you want to copy the derivation, actually this is a derivation, okay, so this is the condition. Okay. You know, are you familiar with ideal gas equation? Are you familiar with ideal gas equation? Correct. PV is equal to nRT. PV is equal to nRT. Okay, students? I don't know their situation. Hello? Can you follow me? Okay, so anyway, from this derivation, P equal to nRT upon V. This is the pressure term, isn't it? Then next one, P equal to n by V, number of moles present per liter of the solution is equivalent to what? RT. What is it? N by V means what? Concentration. So we can represent it with CRT term. Isn't it correct? So this is CRT. So P equal to CRT. How we derive? Due to this kind of n by v is equal to concentration, so we are adding CRT. This much clear. Next one, Kp, you know Kp. So pressure equal to, this is P. Okay, so pressure term, now you got the idea, CRT term. Pressure we can represent CRT form. So can you apply it on the Kp term? Kp term, how you will apply? This is the thing. This one. Kp changed into CdRt. Okay. CdRt into CrT upon CrT square. Clear? This is the next step, RT the whole square. Okay. This much clear? Next step what happened? CD, CA, CR common. So CD, C upon CA. After that, CA square. So RT term is also there now. So what happened? RT. Here 1 RT power 1. Here also 1. 1 plus 1, 2, minus, upside, minus 2. So whatever the result, anything in the power 0 is the 1. So, CD, then after the conclusion it becomes like this, CD, CE upon CA square equal to KP. Okay. Got it? Kp means CD, CE, CA. So Kp equal to Kc now. It is equivalent to Kp, Kc. That much only. So how we can represent? Out of this conclusion, Kp equal to Kc. So one term we can represent it by with the help of this equation. Okay, so we can represent a Kp. Okay, Kp equal to, in general, Kp equal to, in general, generally. That is perfect. No, not like that. Kp equal to, with the help of this equation, this much is Kp or Kp any term. So Kp equal to Kc, we can say Kc into RT all raised to delta n. What do you mean delta n? Total number of moles present in it. So here how many moles? 1 plus 1, 1 mole. Sorry, 2 mole total. That is means delta n means product mole minus n product minus n reaction like this. Any manner, it becomes cancelled. Product minus reaction mole. So in general, we want to study this equation. Kp equal to Kp into RT upon delta n. Study this. RT means what? Sorry, R means what? Gas loss constant, 0.082 atm per liter per mole per liter, like this. Okay, it will helpful for you. JEE Main 2014 questions are repeated. IIT. Okay, we can do accordingly. Can I run? Students understood the thing. With the help of online, nothing is working out, right? Offline only you can get something. Otherwise, I have no idea about your level now. Online now. Kp equal to Kc into Rt raised to delta n. N is product minus reactant. That is very important. Product minus, not reactant minus product. Product minus. We can solve problem. Okay. Very simple only. Within second, but don't make mistake. This is my research. I will write here. Kp equal to Kp into Rt all raised to delta n. The type of question is like this. They will give an equation. Then try to find out the Kp, Kc respectively. Okay. This is your Kp. And Kp, Kc. This is our task. Okay. H2 is in a gas mass. Plus I2 is also in a gaseous form. In equilibrium with 2HI, it is also in gaseous form. Find out Kp, Kc. This week onwards you are in offline mode. Okay. Finished? H2. Tell me. Kp relation, you know, Kp equal to Kc right on same manner. Then Rt. Tell me. Upon, sorry, raise to productive mode 2. Tell me, no problem. 2 minus 2. Cancel. So the relation becomes Kp equal to Kc. Right? Wrong. Right? Wrong. Right? Next question. Higher level we can show. Okay. We'll overflow. N2 nitrogen. N2 plus 3H2. Here gas? Yeah. In equilibrium with the 2NH3. Here also forming a gaseous. Kp gives. I'm checking now what about the relation between Kp and Kc. Okay, what about the relation between Kp and Kc? Here Kp and Kc are equal. Here Kp, Kc relationship I'm checking. You want to create a relation. Again repeat one. One means, are we need, look now. Kp, Kc representation with the help of that is, you know that. Then Rt you want to write. Here number of moles, this is the number of moles, 2. Okay, then product side, 2. Reactant side, here 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1, 2. So the change becomes 2 minus 2, that is equal to 0. So then Pura term neglected. It is equal to Kc into Rt raised to 0. Okay, so Rt, any thing in the power of 0 is considered as a unity. So Kc into 1 equal to Kc. Relationship it is Kc equal to Kc. What is we need? Thumb impression. Okay, anyway. After repeating, making a thumb movie. Sorry, Vinny, you are joking. Okay. What about the relation? Kp equal to Kc Rt whole raised to minus 2. 1 minus minus 2. But one thing. Here delta Ng means what? Delta Ng, it is not equal to 0. It is less than 0 or greater than 0. Minus 2 is delta Ng number. So it is greater than or less than 0. Less than 0. It is, suppose like this. Delta Ng is less than 0. That is the condition. Another question. This is a previous year question. J.E. Main 2014 question. Question is this, SO2 in gas plus O2 also in gas in equilibrium to form SO3 gas. Kp, Kc relationship. Sejal, text me, what about the answer? What about your answer, bro? Minus R, not plus R. Right, sir. We need it. However, we need minus 1. Kp equal to Kc Rt raised to minus 1. Are how? Kp equal to Kc Rt raised to here half plus 1, sorry. 1 minus half plus 1. So this is 3 by 2. 1 minus 3 by 2 is minus half. This is Why minus 1? One more, okay. Two, second one. 2 NO2, nitrogen dioxide. Is in equilibrium with the N2O4. This is gas. Here also gas. Do it. Already done? One more, IIT 2000, repeat your question. Not repeat it, huh? Already done. IIT, IIT 2000. Okay, it's a very previous, I mean, you know 2000 year, but the standard becomes very nice. Because of course IIT papers are like this. Okay, look, N2 plus 3H2 are in equilibrium with the 2NH3. Okay. This is a gas form. This is also gas form. Okay. Then they are telling, question is this. They are given Kp. Kp equal to 1.44 into 10 to the power minus 5. Okay. At 500 degree Celsius. Find it. It is the advanced level, not error. Solve it. Correct? Yeah, here. Yeah, of course, nitrogen. Solve it technique. Values are 0.08. 2.082, that much only. That much enough. Ah. Of course. Kelvin, only everything you want to express in Kelvin. Kelvin. Are why you are in confusion? Because yeah, universal gas constant unit. How you are representing moles per liters per Kelvin like that, no? Catch me, Vinid. What about your answer? Kc equal to. Just solve it or. Tell me at least Kc equal to 1.44 into 10 to the power minus 5 upon 0.082 into 7. RP na? Upon RP le. Ha. RP. C equal to. What is? Tell me answer. Sejal, can you do it with a calculator and tell me an exact answer? I want to compare it with the other's answer. Yeah, Sanjana, you are telling. What is this? Sanjana, what about the remaining portion? Kc equal to 1.44 into 10 to the power minus 5 upon 0.082 into 773 raised to 2. You cut out something. Okay. Oh my god.
This might be because
of it.
So what I did is I took
that in denominator. And then for
this
I did 1.2
the square.
Right? 1.2.
So square cancel.
And only this divided by this. Shortcut, right? Nice. We can reach it now. Keep a calculator, not phone. Calculator, if you have calculator, scientific calculator, you use it, it is nice.
2.05 into 10 raised to minus
2. We can take this calculator. Students, what about your answer? Hello? Text me your answer. Tell me the answer. I thought you were skipped. Your answer around 2.05. Oh, 5 point something?
5.5 into 10 raised to minus
5.5 into 10 to minus 5. Got it?
5 point something.
Okay, so leave it, no problem. Around 5 point something. Apurva, the last answer na, it's around 5.5 minus 2, around this much. Okay, final answer. This much section is over, okay? Next section. Within tomorrow na, we will cover chemical equilibrium. Are you are familiar with this chemical equilibrium on the standard of 11 onwards you are studying this thing. You are okay with this one. But as part of JEE, we want to study both ionic as well as chemical. So chemical is the basic. After that ionic we will start after this. Okay. In ionic we want to study very simple only actually ionic. thermodynamics, physical. Very interesting chapter. After the kinetic, solid state, solid state is there, na? Solid state is there, kinetic is there. Next one is heading characteristics of equilibrium constant. Constant. Characteristics of equilibrium constant. That is K. 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 C. Like this. K. Anyway, we can represent anyhow. K. Like this. Okay. Actually, we are going to tell about the. It is depending upon something. It will does not depend upon something. Some factor. Okay. It is depend upon na. It does not depend upon D O E S. Does not. Does in do what happen? In the concentration of substance. Means initial concentration. How much is the initial? There is no problem. In the final stage only we are deciding everything na. Much in the initial concentration there is no problem. So it does not depend upon initial concentration. Second one, any catalyst or anything is added in it. Okay, catalyst will never depend, right? Is there will never take part in the chemical reaction catalyst. This is the nature of catalyst as well as present the inert material. Any inert material present in it, it will does not depend upon the equilibrium constant. It does not depend. It will never change. Okay, so these are the factors you want to keep in your mind. Catalyst, inert substances. Okay, in case in your question they will give you one inert material, then after that find out the effect of equilibrium constant in it. You know the thing. What do you know? This inert material will does not affect anything. If you know the logic, you can directly apply the question. Okay, but it depends on. Okay, but it is depends on mode of representation of the reaction, mode of representation of the reaction. But it is depend upon mode of representation, means how they are representing. Like suppose A plus B in equilibrium with the C. Okay. Or they are representing like this. Suppose. So here in this reaction, in this representation, we will get K as the equilibrium constant. But in this reaction, you know, just the reverse of the above. So definitely you can imagine what about the equilibrium constant 1/k. 1/k. So this is the meaning how we are representing the equation. The mode of representation of the reaction, that equilibrium constant depending upon the mode of representation of the reaction, mode of representation of reaction. A plus B gives C, so the equilibrium constant becomes K. But if you represent in a reverse order, the equilibrium point becomes definitely changed. But it does not depending upon the initial concentration, catalyst concentration, or any inert material, presence of any inert material. Initial doesn't. Okay. Initial concentration of reactant. This one is catalyst. This is inert material. Point is very very valuable point. Okay, depend upon that point we want to solve some question. We want to solve some question. 5 minutes. कोलेस्ट्रॉल Vineet? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what about your status? Are you getting my point? Characteristics?
Yes, ma'am. It?
Problem. Okay. Sanjana is fluctuating. Problem. Okay. This is the question. N2 plus O2 is in equilibrium. 2-1-2-N. Okay. Having an equilibrium constant is K sub. The next one, 2N2 plus 2O2, okay, 2O2 in equilibrium will get to 4N0. Okay, you want to find out the equilibrium constant K means what? With the help of this K. Very simple. This is a relation. Huh? K square. Okay. So, once again, I'll repeat, students here. Are you getting my point? Answer. This is K. What is the actual meaning of this equation? We want to multiply it by 2. Okay. So, multiply it by 2. So, what happened? You will get K is here. Okay. Then you want to that power na. Power you want to sorry 2 want to represent as a power. Means whatever the relation this is K. So this equation is multiplied by 2. So that power that 2 number 2 here 2 you want to check entire equation. Suppose here is itself. That logic will not work out. So everything you want to keep. Okay, so after that the KE becomes, this is the relationship between KE equal to K square. This coefficient is considered as the square term, power term. Another question, similarly 2SO2 plus O2 equilibrium with 2SO3, this is K, and one more equation they are providing, SO2 plus half O2 in equilibrium with the SO3. Okay, what about the KE, this K relationship? Means power only, power right, power 1 by 2. Because for getting this equation, what do you want to do? You want to multiply it with the 2. Half. Then only it will cancel. So this equation we can multiply it by what happens? 2, this is half, then again 2. So we will get this equation. So what about that power? Sorry, the coefficient? 1 by 2. That is actually K. Raised to 1 by 2. That is equal to K. So, okay, this root K. So, this kind of equation you can expect. So, what do you want to do? This is simple only. What do you want to do? You want to compare. So, are you getting my point, students? Apurva, Sejal, Sanjana, Vineet. This thing clear or not? Okay, done. This is IIT 2006 problem. Okay. IIT 2006 problem. Ag plus NH3 in equilibrium with Ag of NH3 whole concentration plus. So they are providing if equilibrium constant K1 equal to. Solve the problem, right? On. Question. K1 is equal to 3.5 into 10 to the power minus 3. After that, Ag of NH3 of plus, what do you mean by this compound? What is this? Square. Tell me, what is this? Square bracket. Tell me. Your choice. Square bracket, this is a metal, student. Ag is a metal. Instead of the metal, you can see NH3 is a group. Ligand. This is a ligand, this is metal. This is a coordination compound. You want to study? Study? Then? Oh. I will help you. Okay. After physical, we will start inorganic. Hello, so, huh. After that, it again added with the one more NH3 molecule. What happened? Combination NH3 of twice will form. Okay, so Ag of NH3 of twice, then charge becomes same. Plus, because why charge becomes same? These are neutral molecules. Anything become added in it, there is no change in the charge. In case we are adding a chlorine, chlorine is a minus charge. So minus to plus is neutral, so it becomes a neutral form. But in the case of NH3, after addition, there is no change in the charge. Means that NH3 is a neutral. Okay, so here K2 is given. K2 equal to 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, the question is this, find the formation constant, find the formation constant for Ag, NH3 of twice plus. You have become worried about moody in the formation. Nothing. KE. KE is the more formation function. Do it. Okay, okay, they will give one now. Suppose Ag plus plus 2NH3 is in equilibrium with Ag NH3 of twice of plus. So K equal to 1. So suppose they will give this much of blue. Two reactions are with you. Okay. After that, they are doing this kind. Formation constant. This is I am giving you from myself. Okay. But this is the this much only the question, formation constant. So formation constant will have formed in this form. Suppose Ag plus 2NH3, AgNH3 of twice. We want to form. Okay. So what you will do? Correct. We can add. While what happened comparing these two equations. This is a common. Left to right become cancelled out, no doubt. Then you will get it 2NH3, 1H3, 1NH3 will get it. So AG plus will form here. Plus 2NH3 in equilibrium with the remaining term. So how out of these things, then how you find out K? You have K1 plus K2. Is it right? Is it right? Wrong. He's wrong. Can you think? This is a concept. In the case of equilibrium constant, you are adding important make a bond. Addition time, what happens? Equilibrium constant will undergo multiplication. Okay, so here K1 is equilibrium constant, K2 is equilibrium constant, K1 plus K2 is not like that. Equilibrium constant becomes addition time, equilibrium constant become multiplied. In subtraction time, what happens? Equilibrium constant you can subtraction, addition, subtraction. Divided. By you are telling. Okay, division. Okay, here division. Suppose they are multiplying each other. So what is the condition? K1 upon K2 equal to likewise. In this case, K1 into 2. This is clear? So that condition you want to apply in it, then you will get the answer. So what about here? Online students tell me. Sejal, got it? Sanjana, any confusion? Hello? Can I repeat? I want to repeat again. Give me an input or anything, something.
No, no.
Okay, good. Yeah, we need clear. Okay. Apurva, repeat. Okay, Apurva. Listen me. In this type of a question, they are telling, they are given two type of equation. AG, likewise forming a product. In this, something addition and forming a product provided by K1, K2 things. This much only they are giving information. Then they are telling, find the formation constant for a reaction. If they are giving like this, first you want to do one thing, you want to cancel, we want to, if we are adding these two equations, some terms become cancelled out. Okay, some terms become cancelled out. So after cancelling these things, you will get a AG plus 2NH3, this kind of form. After that, you know that these formed by the addition of these two equations. So, equation become added. So, what are the relation between addition equilibrium constant? The equilibrium constants are undergo multiplication. Okay. So, here K1, K2 are the two equilibrium constants. They are undergo multiplication. What happened? They are undergo multiplication. What happened? K1 into K2 formula. K1 is given 3.5, 1.7. Undergo multiplication, you will get the answer. Okay, tell me answer. (5.95), sure? 10⁻¹. Okay, you can, Sanjana, 5.92 into 10⁻¹. Okay, no problem. This is the level of question, understood? You know KCKP, but you don't know the relationship, then how will you apply? So if you have any equation provided into you, what do you want to do? One thing, you want to cancel out first. The remaining is the formation related equation. That equation say you can apply on. Okay, one more area. Okay, in this area, na, how the equilibrium constant very very important. What of questions come from the same area? Okay, equation you want to study. Depend the equilibrium constant depend upon temperature. Relation between equilibrium constant and this temperature. Very very famous equation. Okay. So K is the constant, you know, K or Kc. At a temperature, the given equation is like this: log K2 upon K1. K2 upon K1 is equal to delta H divided by 2.303. Okay. R. Then here you want to represent T2 minus T1 divided by T1 into T2 means 1 by T1, 1 by T2 format. Okay. So condition is this. T2 is always greater than T1. Then only this other, otherwise negative value will form. Nah? That's why. Right. T2 is always greater than T1. Okay. So K2 related. Equilibrium constant K2 related temperature is T2. Equilibrium constant K1 related temperature is T1. Got it? This is the famous equation. Okay, equation. This is our equation constant. Means equilibrium constant, okay. Related to temperature T1 and T2. Very, very important equation, no doubt. So what are the terms? Log value, K2 equilibrium constant, delta H is enthalpy. Okay, change in enthalpy. Delta H is enthalpy of reaction. Okay? Enthalpy. We will study everything in thermodynamics. If you don't know, I will teach you. Thermodynamics. Delta H is enthalpy of reaction or heat, we can say in general. Heat change. Heat releasing. Okay. This much clear. Suppose in this equation I am providing you delta Hc equal to 0. What is the meaning? There is no heat change. Heat change means suppose this is a system. Okay. System means heat become releasing. Heat become absorbing. So heat releasing, absorbing, that time we can say that that system containing a change in heat. In case delta H equal to 0 meaning what? How many heat is given? That much heat also absorbed. There is no change in heat. The meaning. Suppose we are applying it. What happens? Log is K2 upon K1 equal to 0. When K2 upon K1 equal to 0? Log equal to 1. Sorry. Log 1. Okay. Log 1 equal to 0. So that K2 upon K1 equal to 1 only. K2 upon K1 is equal to 1. So K2 equal to, this is the relation. Okay. When? Condition 1. When delta H equal to 0. Now you are thinking that, oh ma'am, very, very easy. We can easily. But they will give you a statement or related question. The change in enthalpy of the system is in zero. There is no change in enthalpy. What happening in the equilibrium constant, the relation between equilibrium constant, what about the relation between? So they will give you four options. First one, the K1 become very, very higher than K2. K2 is very, very higher than K1. It's negligible or it is both are equal. Which one? You will select both are equal. So that's why statement related theory based question also you can expect from this section. So don't leave these kind of points. Keep in your mind. Okay. When enthalpy equal to 0. Or they can ask another type of question. How? In a reaction, both K1 and K2 are what? Equal in nature. What about the nature of enthalpy? Change in enthalpy. They can ask. So look, students, what I am suggesting, while you are studying a question, you want to think reverse manner also. If they are providing that, how you will find this one? If they are providing this one, how they will find out that one? So both condition you want to shift, then only you will get the proper answer. Okay. This is the first condition, students. One more thing. Here, na delta H is equal to 0. Here, K1, K2 upon K1 equal to 1 in nature. So, one more condition, one more important point is given from this equation. Do you know what is that? It is second point. First point, delta H equal to 0. Second point, K2 equal to K1. Second point, third point, they are independent of temperature. Independent of temperature, because in this situation there is no role of temperature. So these things are noted. Okay, independent of temperature, K2, K1 are in equal in nature, delta H is equal to 0. These are the after effect of enthalpy becomes 0 type. Independent of temperature. Okay? Independent of is it clear? Another case we want to study. This is the first case. Another case. Second case. Suppose. Cases are very important. Don't neglect these things. Okay. Suppose delta H is negative, student. Delta H is negative. Here delta H is 0. Delta H is negative. What are the changes will happen here? Any idea? And delta H negative means what? Delta H less than 0. Anything delta H is less than 0, that is exothermic. You already, delta H is negative. Delta H is negative is called what? Exothermic reaction. So reaction, they question, they can ask like this. If delta H is negative in nature or less R, so what about the type of heat exchange we can expect in it? Exothermic means what? Releasing. The heat will move outside, towards outside, not inside. Okay? This is the another term. Okay, delta H is negative. You want to apply the same thing into the another equilibrium constant. What happened? You want to check the same method for another thing also. Suppose delta H is negative. What happened in the case of yogurt? K2 upon K1. That also less than 0. Are you getting my point? So here what happened? K2 or K1, which one is higher? K2 want to? Yeah, no. Negative value we want to form. So which one is higher? K2 or K1? K1 must be higher, no K2. K2 is greater than K1. K2 is less than K1. Okay. So actually what is the meaning? This is K2, this is K1. K2 is less, K1 is higher. So overall K becomes decrease or increase? Overall K becomes decrease. Okay. This is the point. This is clear. One more point. Can you accept? Can you predict? What about the third point? What happened? Delta H equal to positive. So delta H is greater than zero. So it is a endothermic reaction. Then what happened? K2 greater than K1. So K becomes increased. Overall K becomes increased. This much confusion is very, very important. During the numerical time, they can ask indirectly, not directly. Nobody will ask directly. What about the change? They will ask some numerical manner. You want to apply this concept on. Okay. So exothermic, endothermic. These three statements study well. But here, as a student, temperature become increasing. Okay, so temperature increases. Here also temperature increases because heat exchange become. So temperature increases. Here K decreases. Here temperature increases. K increases. So exothermic reaction. Temperature increases. What happens? K increases. In this case, temperature increases. Time. What happens? K decreases. Here. Independent of temperature, right? Actually, what is this? It's an equilibrium manner. Nothing will happen, nothing will form, na? So, equilibrium condition, independent of temperature. So that K2 equal to K1. Already given, na? Independent of temperature. So these point, note down, take time, revise properly. Clear on physical. Small topic. We can start after that. We can take a break. Half an hour. Can I rub students? This much clear? Condition? This much clear? Sanjana? Okay. Sajal? Where you are? Vineet? Vineet? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I rub the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Look, ma'am, if you are able to know the basics of chemical equilibrium, very easy for ionic equilibrium. Next one, that is degree of dissociation. Are you familiar? Degree of dissociation. Represented by letter alpha. Degree of dissociation. Next question. Certainly, theory degree of dissociation is degree of dissociation of CCl5. Suppose CCl5 is equal to 4 into 4. You don't know the concept of degree of dissociation. Don't know. But blankly you want to remember DOD of PCl5 is 0.4 like this. I'm telling you. Okay. And then they are given a question, their equation. PCl5 gaseous form in equilibrium with the PCl3 in gas form plus Cl2 as a gas will form. Okay. Actually, what is the meaning? Dissociation of PCl5. Any idea? This much quantity dissociated. Any idea? Simply, listen me. In the initial, these are reactants. Sure. These are products, no doubt. Okay. In this initial level, this reactant around 1 mole. 1 mole only. Okay. But after that, what happened? This is initial condition, initial. Of course you know that nothing will form initial level. Because 1 mole. 0, 0. Both are 0, 0. But after equilibrium, what happened? During the equilibrium time, what happened? Out of 1, something is dissociated. 0.4 molecule is dissociated. Dissociated, 0.4. Okay. This is the thing. Same manner, how much dissociated, that much 0.2 or 0.2 become formed there. Are you getting my point? So how much dissociated, that much is formed there. This is called what the degree of dissociation. Okay. In a total, how many dissociated? How many? Total. Suppose 4 molecules are total. Out of 4, only 2 only dissociated. So alpha is the ratio. Out of total, how many dissociated? You can write down a definition. Number of moles dissociated per mole of the reactant during equilibrium. What do you mean by dissociation? Number of moles. Alpha dissociate, DOD, degree of dissociation means number of moles dissociated. Number of moles dissociated per mole of the reactant. Only in case of reactant students, not about case of product. No matter how much product you have, but in case of reactant. So number of moles dissociated per mole of the reactant during equilibrium condition. This is the notable point. Okay. During equilibrium condition is called what? Degree of dissociation represented by the letter alpha. Degree of dissociation represented by the letter alpha. One more thing, the range of alpha na degree of dissociation, alpha must be between 0 and 1. Okay? 0 like this. Means the alpha is in between, means this range is 0 1. So maximum range of alpha is 1. So alpha, students, I am asking, alpha is equal to 1. Find out the meaning. Correct. Yes. Alpha is, this point you want to come to your mind and only become applicable. That's why I'm asking you. Okay. Good. So alpha equal to 1 means complete the arsen is going to produce, complete dissociation will happen. Look now, what happened? Four molecules out of four become dissociated. This is the meaning now. So 4 by 4 = 1. So alpha equal to 1 means the complete dissociation. Then alpha is equal to less than 0.5 is possible, 0.3, 0.9 is possible, but minus 1, minus 2, that kind of negative value is not possible. So that the conclusion is that dissociation, this is the definition, this is the thing, so alpha is, it should be in the range of 0.1. 1 means complete dissociation. 0 means nothing will happen. We can conclude that also. How? Because 0 upon 4 now. 0 upon 4, reaction is same. There is no dissociation will happen. Okay. Now we can take break. Okay, students, we can take break. After that, sharp 4:30, join with me. 4:30.